Hello students, welcome to Presentia online class. As you all know that we are going through a very critical situation due to the outbreak of COVID-19. You are very aware of this. So in such situation, your teaching learning process is completely disturbed. You are not able to go to your colleges taking proper coaching classes. So you students are at loss to some extent. So by keeping in view this circumstance, your well-being, your interest for studies, Presentia online class is trying to give you some study materials, videos, lectures, so that by sitting at your home, you can have access to your studies, so that you won't lag behind in such lockdown situation also. So in this video, first of all, I would like to give a brief idea about commerce stream. What are the subjects you can have? What are the combination of subjects you can have when you are going to take admission in college in commerce stream? So let's see what are the subjects, what are the combination of subjects that you can have when you will take admission in commerce stream in any of the college of your choice. First subject that you will have in commerce stream is accountancy. This subject is compulsory, you have to this subject. Number two, business studies. Again, it is compulsory that you must have these two subjects, accountancy, business studies. Number three, economics, / CMST, commercial mathematics and statistics. These two subjects, you can take any one of the subject, or if you want to like to take both the subjects, you can, provided keeping one subject as your fourth subject. Otherwise, you can choose any of the subject of your choice. So in number three, you have choice. Come to number four, English. English, you all know very well, it is your compulsory subject. Number five, this number five is also your compulsory subject, but here what you have options. Alternative English. Or Bengali, or Manipuri, or Hindi. So among these subjects, you can take options as your choice, but whatever subjects you will be choosing, this will be your compulsory subject. So this is a very structure of your commerce stream, accountancy, business studies, economics or CMST, English, and number five, alternative English, Bengali, Manipuri or Hindi, depends on your choice. So this is the very structure of your commerce stream. So this is the combination that you will have to when you are taking admission in the college. As I am your English teacher, so in today's video, I would like to give you a clear idea, a complete idea of the syllabus of English for the class HS first year. So let's discuss the syllabus. You will come to know what are the things, what are the marks distribution that you have in your subject English, which is very much important to know before going through any of the subjects. You need to know what is the syllabus, what kind of marks that you have. So let's talk about your English syllabus. First of all, we will talk about books, textbooks. In regarding textbooks, you have two books, you need to buy two books. First one is Hornbill. This is your main textbook. Then the next one, Snapshot. This is supplementary. These two books you need to buy, Hornbill and Snapshot. Both the books are compulsory. First one is your main textbook and the second one is your supplementary book. This portion will be covering 40 marks. How these marks will cover, we will discuss one by one. Now let us see the marks distribution step by step. Your whole syllabus of English is divided into 5 sections. Now let us see the marks distribution. Section A, as I told you that you will have 5 sections. So first, section A, where you will have 20 marks. Then section B, again 20 marks. Then section C, 10 marks, section D, 40 marks and section E 10 marks. See now it is covering your 100 marks. 20 plus 20 plus 10 plus 40 plus 10. It is covering your 100 marks. From section A to section D, it is written. You will be given the question paper in examination hall of 90 marks. But regarding your section E, it is your oral. You will have oral section for section E and where it will be covering 10 marks. Now let us see step by step what are the things, what are the topics you will have in all the five sections. Now let's see. First of all, we will discuss section A. The name of the section is reading skill. This section, as I told you already, 20 marks, cover 20 marks. Here we will have passages. One is unseen passages. You all know what unseen passages, as you have done in the last class. It will cover 12 marks, number one. Number two, you will have note making. This topic may be new to you. Don't worry, we will discuss. You will understand. So reading skill, unseen passage and note making. These two topics will be covering your section A, where you have 20 marks, 12 plus 8. So I think it is clear to you. Now we will discuss section B. It is called your section, name of the section B is writing skill. Again covers 20 marks. Writing skill, so what are the topics you can have in this section, we will discuss. Number one, you will have factual description. Here we will have option or report writing. You all know what report writing is, because in the last class you have what report writing is. It factual description may be new to you, but don't worry, it is as easy as paragraph writing. And report writing known to many of you. This topic will cover 6 marks. Remember, you have to do any one, not both the things. If you want to do both the things, you can. But if you want to choose, you can choose anyone from this topic. Number two, speech writing or article writing. Again, it will cover 6 marks. These topics may be new to some of the students, but these are not new to the CBSE students. They know all these things because they have done in their classes. So speech writing or article writing, it will cover 6 marks. Anyone you will do. Number 3, letter writing. It will cover 8 marks. So letter writing, it is done by all the students. You have to do letter writing. So you know many of the topics. Some of the topics may be new to you. But what are the topics will be new? You don't worry, we will discuss one by one. You can understand the things very easily. So this, the three things, one, two, three, here we have options. Factual description or report writing, 6 marks. Speech writing or article writing, 6 marks. And letter writing is compulsory, where you have 8 marks. This portion again is covering 20 marks. So we have covered up to section B. Now we will see what we have in section C. Section C. Here we have grammar. This portion only covers 10 marks. In class HS first year, you don't have many grammars. Some of the topics which are very common, these topics you only have. It will be covering only 10 marks. Number one, determiners. Number two, correct tense. Number three, editing task. Number four, correction. Number five, model auxiliaries. And number six, sentences. determiners, correctants, editing task, correction, model auxiliaries and sentences. Some of the things are well known to you all, determiners, correctants, correction, you all know all these things. Some of the things may be new to you, sentences, model auxiliaries and editing task. But we will discuss these things, you can understand these things are very easy. And here you have only 10 marks, not so much very marks, only 10 marks will be covering this section C. So we have already covered 20 plus 20 plus 10 means 50 marks we have already covered. Now we will discuss section D, and section D is of your textual section. It will cover your whole text. I have already told you we have two texts. Hornbill is your main text and snapshot is your supplementary text. Section D we have text where it will cover 40 marks. Now how it will cover 40 marks? I will show you. Hornbill 30 marks and snapshot 10 marks, 40 marks. So from Hornbill you have 4 poems and 4 proses. Very easy poems and very easy proses. So all total we have 8 chapters from Hornbill, 4 poems and 4 proses, and from snapshot only 2 chapters. From the 2 chapters you have to cover this 10 marks. So from Hornbill the questions will be like this, 1, 2, 3, sometimes it may be 4, sometimes may be 5, it depends on the person who will set your question paper. But from snapshot questions are very rigid, you have just 2 chapters covering 10 marks, just like 6 plus 4. For 6 marks you have 2 broad questions along with options. Just like 6A, 6B, you need to answer only one. It will be covering your 6 marks. And 4 marks will be 2 plus 2. Here we will be given 4 options. From 4 options, you have to answer only 2 questions. Sometimes first students do, they go for only one chapter from these 2 chapters. It will do their purpose, but sometimes it is risky. Sometimes it may be like this, 3 plus 3, 6. First portion is from one chapter and second portion is from another chapter. So I suggest you to go for both the chapters, and for your 2 marks question you have to go for both the chapters. So don't go for shortcut, you have to go all through the chapters, then only you can answer 90 marks from your written question paper. Otherwise it is not always possible to answer all the questions. So you have only 4 poems and 4 prose and 2 chapters, not so big syllabus. You have to go through all the chapters, then only you can answer all the questions in your exam hall. So 20 plus 20 plus 10 plus 40, we have covered 90 marks, and this 90 marks for your written questions. What we have remaining 10 marks. 10 marks is for section E. Name of section E is conversation skill. Here we have to show your 2 skills. One is listening, another is speaking. As I told you, 10 marks, 5 marks here and 5 marks is in speaking. So what the name of the portion is also called oral section. So what we have to do in this section is that for listening, you will be sitting in the examination hall and one passage will be read to you. This passage, not very big, consisting of 10 to 12 lines, will be read to you by the teachers for 3 to 4 times. And when they will read the passage, in front of you there will be the question paper where you have to just tick the right answer. You will be listening to the passage and in front of you have the questions. On the basis of your listening, you will tick the right answers. So out of 5, easily you can get 4. It is very easy. So this is about your listening. And speaking, what you have to do, after listening portion, they will call one by one by your roll number. Then they will ask you questions. They will ask you questions in English. Questions like, what is your name? Why do you like this college? What is the most important thing of the college that you have liked? These are the questions, very simple questions they will ask to you, and you have to answer in English. So this is the स्पीकिंग स्किल वेयर यू हैव 5 मार्क्स. अगेन यू कैन गेट 5 out of 5 और नॉट इवन ऑल्सो 4. तो फ्रॉम दिस सेक्शन ई यू आर इजिली गेटिंग 8, इजंट इट? एंड फ्रॉम अदर सेक्शन, सेक्शन ए बी सी डी, मीन्स आउट ऑफ 90 मार्क्स यू कैन इजिली गेट 75, इवन 80 ऑल्सो. तो इट इज इजी टू गेट 90, 95, इवन 100 ऑल्सो इफ यू गो थ्रू द सिलेबस वेरी सिस्टमेटिकली. It may be seem to you that English syllabus is very lengthy, divided into 5 sections, but this is not at all. It seems lengthy, rather it is very, very scoring. When you go through the syllabus very systematically, very step by step, you can understand all the things given very minutely, just for your well-being, so that you can score very well. And in English subject, it is easier than other subjects to get 80. I'm just talking about letter marks. But if you give some extra concentration, you can easily get 90, 92. Not to get 100, it is also not difficult. So this is the syllabus, section A, B, C, D, E, covering 100 marks, 90 marks for your written and 10 marks for your oral. I think you understand the syllabus very well. Go through the video very carefully. You can understand the things, what are the things that you have in your syllabus very properly. And it is important to understand the syllabus, because without understanding the syllabus you cannot go through the whole course, isn't it? So go through the syllabus very systematically, very step by step, you can understand each and everything. And these two books, Hornbill and Snapshot, you need to buy. Without these two books you cannot go for your English course. So this much I want to say about your English syllabus. I hope you understand. So do like the video and subscribe our channel for more upcoming videos. And if your other friends don't know about the video, tell them so that they can get also benefit from the video. This online coaching class is just for your benefit, so that you people will be benefited. During this lockdown period, there should not be any loss, there should not be any harm in your teaching learning process. So this much I want to say. And remember one thing, this whole course is same for all the streams. Science, commerce, arts, same for all the streams. So this much I want to say. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.